So let's be sure everybody understands. So when you're talking about doing a deal on a wrap, let's unpack that for a little bit.
Okay.
So you're doing a deal on a wrap. You got two notes involved in this transaction. You got one note over here from the seller of a house. The seller of the house has agreed to sell it to you, Nick, your entity, you know, your student's entity, whatever. You're buying it, and instead of borrowing money from the bank or using private money, the seller is agreeing to sell it with seller finance, and therefore they're taking back a note and you owe them. Now, the wrap, we're going to sell that house still creatively, but how is this second note a wrap, and why is it called a wrap?
Well, it's called a wrap because that's exactly what we're doing here. So we have let's call this the underlying Bank of America mortgage for $100,000 at 3%. And we're going to maybe put $10,000 in it, give the seller maybe another $10,000. And we're going to sell it for, let's say, $180,000. And we're going to charge maybe 8%. So that new mortgage that we write is a wrap, and it goes on top of it. So technically, the wrap mortgage is a junior lien or in second lien position to whatever the underlying debt might be in the form of the bank. And that's basically the difference. So I'm going to owe Bank of America, because of the agreement that we say, maybe 3% on $100,000 of balance, but I'm going to collect another maybe $150,000 at 8%, and the difference is what we call arbitrage. And that is when you run amortization schedules, you can really see the benefit or the effect of that over time, as long as you can hold that note in place.